Skyrora, founded in 2017 in Scotland, is on a mission to become the first UK-based startup to send a payload into orbit. The company's CEO, Volodymyr Levkin, originally from Ukraine, drew inspiration from Elon Musk and, with the boost in attention from venture capitalists after SpaceX came on the scene, he decided to start his own venture. Skyrora aims to offer a space taxi service providing customised launch solutions tailored to clients' needs, with a primary focus on capturing the small launcher market before expanding further. Located in Edinburgh, with additional facilities scattered across Europe, Skyrora is dedicated to designing and constructing launch vehicles. Their goal is to meet the increasing demand for small satellite launches by merging tried and true technologies with modern innovations such as 3D printing, ensuring both cost effectiveness and reliability in space access. Their team have a deep knowledge and experience within the aerospace sector. Check out the breakdown of their team members, covering rocket wranglers, software nerds, electronic geeks, and academic brain power. In addition to their highly experienced team, they have reached out into the aerospace sector and established a number of partners, as can be seen from the graphic. Once operating at full capacity, Skyrora expects to conduct up to 16 launches per year. Okay, now we have covered the basics of the company and the team, let's look at the technology they are developing. As is now common with space startups, Skyrora is taking full advantage of 3D printing, or additive manufacturing to give the technology its proper name. Skyrora boasts the largest hybrid 3D printer in Europe called Skyprint 2. The company's 3D printers can construct various components using different alloys, from Inconel to titanium and aluminium alloys, plus other super alloys. In testing of their 3D printed components, the company has found them to be mechanically robust, passing all the testing procedures. Ecosene. Another innovation from Skyrora is their rocket fuel. It's an environmentally friendly rocket fuel that is produced from unrecyclable plastic waste and converted into high-grade aerospace fuel. The production of Ecosene, Skyrora's proprietary ecofuel, will remove over 3,000 tons of unrecyclable plastic waste by 2030. Their rocket fuel manufacturing process produces 70% less CO2 emissions than classic methods of fuel production. Their low-temperature process prevents formation of compounds such as dioxins and furans. The feedstock for making Ecosene can be polypropylene, polyester or polystyrene, all types of plastic waste. Okay, let's turn our attention to the rockets. Skyrora is developing a number of rockets. The first is a suborbital rocket that acts as a tech demonstrator for its larger orbital rocket. Skylark L. Skylark L is a single-stage suborbital rocket launched from a fixed launch pad. This suborbital rocket is equipped with a guidance package, roll control system and thrust vector control system. From the specs on the website, we can see it has a payload mass of 50 kilos, maximum altitude is 102 kilometers, which is achieved after 225 seconds of flight. The launch pad. Skyrora is manufacturing every part of the launch pad. Most of the launch pad components have completed testing, with a few remaining parts in the final stages of testing. Now on to the larger rocket, Skylark XL. Skyrora's flagship orbital rocket, the Skylark XL, is a three-stage vehicle designed to deploy up to 315 kilos of payload into orbit. This rocket is specifically engineered for missions targeting sun-synchronous orbits at altitudes between 500 kilometers and 1,000 kilometers, as well as for placing payloads into polar orbits ranging from 200 kilometers to 1,000 kilometers. The first stage of the Skylark XL is powered by 9 Skyforce bipropellant engines, each generating 70 kilonewtons of thrust at sea level. The fuel emits half the carbon emissions of engines using liquid oxygen and kerosene. Skyrora's non-cryogenic propellant is a more stable fuel that doesn't need constant cooling. The second stage features a single Skyforce engine, optimized for vacuum conditions, delivering 85 kilonewtons of thrust. The third stage, equipped with a reignitable engine, provides 3.5 kilonewtons of thrust, allowing for precise orbital adjustments and accurate payload deployments. Some of the technical details about the third stage are thrust vector control of pitch and yaw, three-axis cold gas attitude control, guidance navigation and control systems, cabin frame, and potential for dispenser installation. Launch of payload into orbit at an altitude between 500 kilometers and 1,000 kilometers. One of the vehicles Skyrora is working on is a space tug. The space tug, originally designed from the upper stage of the Skyrora XL launch vehicle, has been modified to endure the harsh conditions of space. This tug can operate not only with its original launch vehicle, but it is also adaptable for use with other partner launch systems. Its primary benefit lies in its ability to deploy numerous satellites from just one launch, significantly cutting down the frequency of rocket launches needed. This feature is particularly crucial in today's market, where satellite constellations are essential for meeting customer demands efficiently. Skyrora believes the space tug could address the escalating issue of orbital debris in low Earth orbit. By clearing this clutter and deorbiting defunct satellites, it would not only benefit all space operators, but also aligns with the goals of the European Space Agency. Let's go over some of the key milestones achieved by Skyrora so far. In April 2021, Skyrora boosted by European Space Agency funding. Skyrora received €3 million of co-funding from the European Space Agency. The funding, which is part of ESA's Boost program, will be used by Skyrora to complete the crucial technology required to deliver consistent orbital launches from the UK with the Skyrora XL launch vehicle. This project plans to create over 170 high-skilled jobs in the UK. Skyrora has established its comprehensive rocket engine testing and manufacturing facilities in Scotland. ESA's funding will allow Skyrora to complete the setup of their larger engine test complex, complete their 70 kN Skyforce engine program, and static fire test the first and second stages of Skyrora XL. In October 2021, Skyrora has agreed a multi-launch deal with the Saxavord spaceport in Scotland. This agreement could result in the first rocket going to space from the UK. This agreement with Saxavord lasts for a decade, giving Skyrora time to scale up its target of 16 launches a year by 2030. Skyrora is based in Scotland, so having an agreement with a Scottish spaceport is great for speed of execution and testing for the company. Saxavord is increasingly becoming recognised as a major spaceport in Europe, with both High Impulse and RFA launching from there. Commenting on the deal, Volodymyr Levkin, Skyrora's founder and CEO, said, "We have made no secret of our ambition to be the first company to launch from UK soil, so it's really exciting to agree this multi-launch deal with Saxavord. We are proud to be at the forefront of space innovation in the UK, deploying our assets and helping to unlock exciting opportunities as part of the new space economy. The UK is a world leader in space technology, and this latest move brings us another crucial step closer to offering a significant space service from our own soil." In March 2022, Skyrora opens the UK's largest rocket engine testing facility to take the lead in the British orbital launch race. Skyrora hits another significant milestone as it scales up its operations in preparation for an orbital launch, with the opening of a new rocket engine testing facility in Scotland. Located in Midlothian, the site increases Scotland's space infrastructure, adding to Skyrora's portfolio of development, manufacturing and testing facilities across the country. This testing facility will be the largest of its kind in the UK. It will help close the loop of the space infrastructure sector in the UK. The UK is the leader in space sensors, satellites and components, but doesn't have a launch capability yet. The stand was designed, manufactured and commissioned in less than 8 months, making it one of the world's fastest stands to be built. The site was made possible in part by a grant awarded in 2021 by the European Space Agency as part of its mission to foster new commercial space transportation services. The Midlothian site, occupying an area of over 120,000 square feet, that's just over 2 football fields, will serve a team of up to 20 engineers once the testing site is running at full capacity. So far, the site has already seen 15 engine tests completed, with regular weekly tests being conducted. Skyrora's engines are deep into verification testing at the new facility. In May 2022, Skyrora completes 70 kN engine tests in line with ESA's Boost program. Skyrora has successfully completed a 70 kN rocket engine test, marking a key milestone in its contract under the European Space Agency's Commercial Space Transportation Services and Support Programme. This completed milestone unlocks the next round of qualification tests and moves the company one step closer to its goal of orbital launch. This test, the latest in a series of 16, lasted 20 seconds, was completed with acceptable parameters, and was conducted using a different propellant mixture ratio. Skyrora will now scale up its manufacturing process and will oversee qualification tests on one engine a week. The 70 kN rocket engine is unique in its design and will be the first stage combustion engine on high test peroxide when qualified. Skyrora's orbital engine, which was designed and produced on-site at the company's recently launched new vehicle assembly facility and with the support of ESA's boost program, is a critical component of Skyrora's XL orbital vehicle, used on the first and second stages. The engine will now be disassembled and refurbished ahead of qualification testing, which will bring Skyrora closer to propulsion system integration and stage testing. In August 2022, second stage static fire engine tests move Skyrora closer to UK launch. Skyrora has successfully completed the static fire test of the second stage of its flagship Skyrora XL orbital rocket. Achieving this latest milestone moves Skyrora one crucial step closer to entering commercial operations, with an inaugural orbital launch now scheduled for spring 2025 from the Saxavord Space Centre in northern Scotland. The test involves hot firing the second stage engine to prove the vehicle's operational capability for its intended payloads and to ensure that its performance meets all the design requirements. It was successfully completed with all systems nominal throughout the 22nd burn and with a single 70 kN liquid engine operated within design margins and achieved the expected thrust. Part of a three-stage launch vehicle, the second stage of Skyrora XL will start its engines at an altitude of approximately 62 kilometers before the third stage is fired at around 190 kilometers to achieve orbital velocity at 28,000 kilometers per hour. The first stage of Skyrora's XL is currently in construction with hot fire tests due to take place in mid-2023. In October 2022, failure of the Skyrora Skylark L from Iceland. Skyrora conducted the first launch test of the Skylark L single-stage rocket from Iceland. After departing the launch pad, an anomaly occurred that prevented the rocket from reaching its intended altitude. A statement from Skyrora said, "Skyrora recently conducted the first test launch of our suborbital Skylark L vehicle from the northeast of Iceland. After leaving the launch pad, an anomaly cut the vehicle's maiden flight short, and it landed safely in the Norwegian Sea, approximately 500 meters away from the launch site. Following a thorough investigation into the root cause by our team of specialists, it was concluded that all mechanical systems aboard the vehicle were nominal, and that the anomaly was ultimately caused by a software complication. The team will use this valuable data collected through the test launch to resolve this issue ahead of future launches." In October 2023, Skyrora, Viasat, and CGI collaborate on new space-based telemetry solutions for launch vehicles. In October 2023, Skyrora, Viasat, and CGI joined forces to develop a pioneering space-based telemetry system named InRange, under contract with the European Space Agency through its Commercial Space Transportation Services program. This system aims to revolutionize how data is collected during rocket launches by ensuring continuous, cost-effective data transmission. The project will demonstrate how InRange can maintain telemetry data transmission from launch to payload deployment using Viasat's global satellite communications network. The initial phase includes ground testing by Viasat to validate the InRange solution with Skyrora's launch vehicle systems. Meanwhile, CGI will conduct a market study to evaluate the commercial viability of this technology across the broader launch services industry. Traditionally, launch vehicles lose contact with ground stations once they move beyond the horizon. InRange, however, uses geostationary satellites to overcome this limitation, allowing for uninterrupted data flow from the launch vehicle to the service provider throughout the mission. This advancement addresses a significant challenge in the launch sector, enhancing both flexibility and efficiency. Okay, on to upcoming events. Skyrora hopes to launch its first suborbital mission from British soil in the spring of 2025, following a year of delays caused by licensing issues. They now expect the application to be processed by mid-December of 2024, with a suborbital launch from Saxavord expected to follow shortly afterwards, most likely in spring 2025. Okay, that wraps up our video on Skyrora. We can't wait for them to launch from Saxavord soon. We'll keep you informed of their progress and wish them the best of luck. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe. From rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more, if it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.